So in the previous lecture, we were discussing about analysis of trusses, and we discussed the various methods used for the analysis of trusses. You might have gone through all those things. We discussed about method of joints and method of sections. And while discussing the methods available for the analysis of trusses, I told you there are four methods are available. That is method of joints, method of sections, tension coefficient method, and graphical method. For GER exam, all the methods which are important are method of joints and method of sections. And we started with actually the assumptions of trusses. What is a truss? What are the basic assumptions we have taken for analyzing a truss? And after that, we started our zero force member concept. We discussed three cases there. Case number one, when two non-bilinear members are meeting at a joint and the joint is not having an external force or external reaction, then those two non-bilinear members are zero force members, or those two members will carry zero force. Then after that, case two, three members are meeting at a joint and the joint is not having an external force or external reaction. Then, and out of those three members, two of them are collinear, then the third non-collinear member will be a zero force member. Then case number three, two non-collinear members are meeting at a joint and one external force or external reaction is acting at that joint, but in the direction of one of the member, then the other member will be a zero force member. And we have discussed how to apply this concept in various trusses or various questions to make the question easier, right? Zero force members, actually it's not a method of analysis, but it will make the analysis simpler, right? Then after that, we discussed about method of joints. While discussing the method of joints, I told you when we use method of joints, we have to start from that joint where the maximum number of unknowns are two, right? Why it is limited to two unknowns? Anyone? Why the number of unknowns at a joint is limited to a maximum of two? Yes, why? Because the force system there is coplanar concurrent force system. For a coplanar concurrent force system, number of equilibrium equations available is 2. That is, equations available are 2. That is sigma fx is equal to 0, sigma fy is equal to 0. 2 equations, so that maximum 2 unknowns. Then we discussed about the method of sections. When we talk about method of sections, we have to cut a section passing through that member whose member force has to be determined. And while cutting the section, we have to keep one thing in our mind. The section must not pass through more than 3 members. Why it is limited to maximum of 3 members? Why? Because when I cut a section, the forces will be released. When a section passes through a member, force in that member will be released. When I cut a section through a truss, it will become a coplanar non-concurrent force system. For a coplanar non-concurrent force system, equilibrium equations available are 3. That is sigma fx is equal to 0, sigma fy is equal to 0, and finally sigma m is equal to 0. 3 equations, so that maximum 3 number of unknowns. So we were solving some questions. I hope till now everything is clear to you. If you have any doubts, you can ask me. Then shall we continue? Actually, in the previous lecture, I think we didn't solve two more questions were there, I guess. So we will start from there, and eventually we will get into methods of structural analysis, right? So we have our secondary screen here today. I'll be giving you the question. So this is the question for you. It's an IES question. Everyone can start solving this question. I'll read the question for you. A simply supported truss shown in the figure carries a load as shown. A load is given that of 100 kN is applied at the center of the truss. The force in the member AB is, it's an IES question as I told you. Options are also given there. And he's asking us to find the force in member AB. Everyone please write. I hope the question is visible to you, right? Is it visible to you? Please reply. Yes, fine. Yes. Everyone please try to find the answer for that question. A simply supported truss shown in the figure carries a load as shown. That is 100 kN given there. The force in the member AB is, we have to find the force in the member AB. Yes, please give me the answer. It's a very simple question, asked for 1 mark in IES exam. Meanwhile, I will try to draw the figure here. Find the force in the member AB, that's the question. Others, please try and give me the answer. We have to find the force in member AB. In the previous lecture, we learned the various methods for finding the force in various members in the truss. We learned the method of joints, we learned method of sections, and we discussed about the concept of zero force members also. So use all those methods. All the methods should go through in your mind. Then choose an appropriate method and get the answer. Okay. So I'm going to solve it. See, as you can see, this is a statically determinate truss. He is asking us to find the force in this member AB. As I told you, if you want, we can choose the method of sections or method of joints. It's as per our convenience. See, I'm going to prefer or I'm going to choose the method of section here. Why? Because if I choose the method of joints, what I have to do? I have to start from joint by joint, right? When I reach us here, gate exam will be over. It will consume more time. So we have to save our time. We are going to use our method of sections. As per method of sections, if I want to find the force in one of the members, what I have to do? I have to cut a section through that member and the section cut must not pass more than 3 members. Right now, when I cut a section like this, force in this member will be released, force in this member will be released, force in this member will be released. I am taking the force in this member, I am taking it as F1, that is not relevant to us. And I am taking this force in this member as FAB. I am taking force in this member as F in FAB, which we have to found out, right now. So coming to this member, I am taking it as F2, which is also not relevant to us. Then after that, what I have to do, I have to take the free body diagram right or left of the section. I have to consider the free body diagram of the truss to the right, to the left or right. So this is the section I am going to choose. So I am going to choose the left section or left part of the section of the truss. And before that, we have to find the support reactions. As you can see, we don't have to use sigma m is equal to 0, sigma m is equal to 0, sigma m b is equal to 0, or sigma moment about this support is equal to 0, or sigma moment about this support is equal to 0. We don't have to go for that. Why? Because it is a symmetrical loading case. The loading or the support reactions will be equal. Total load is 100 kN. Reaction at this support will be 50 kN or 100 divided by 2. It will be around 50 kN. Here also reaction will be there. The reaction will be equal to 50 kN. Right? So I am going to choose only the one part of the truss. I can either choose the right part or the left part. I am going with the left part. So how to find the FAB or the force in the member AB? How to do that? I have to use the equations of equilibrium. That is sigma Fx is equal to 0, sigma Fy is equal to 0 and sigma M is equal to 0 conveniently. Which equation will I use here? Will I use sigma Fx is equal to 0? Or will I use sigma Fy is equal to 0? Or will I go with sigma M is equal to 0? Which equation will I prefer here? Please tell me, which equation will I prefer here? Yes, I am going to go with, I am going to use sigma Fy is equal to 0. When I use sigma Fx is equal to 0, I have F2 here, I have F1 here, I have FAB cos theta here, if this is theta. Right now, if I use sigma M is equal to 0, sigma moment about this point, I will not get FAB. If I want to get FAB, I want to use the equation sigma Fy is equal to 0. Consider sigma Fy is equal to 0, that is sum of the forces in the vertical direction is equal to 0. I am considering only the free body diagram of the left part of the truss. To make it more understanding, you can consider this as a rigid portion. You can consider it like this. To make it a free body diagram, or to consider the free body diagram, you can forget this also. You don't have to consider this. I am considering only the part of the truss which is left to the section, which is left to the section. Now it is clear, right? Three forces are released, F1, FAB, F2, and one support reaction is also there. What are the forces in the vertical direction? What are the forces available in the vertical direction? Yes, we have the support reaction here and the horizontal, so the vertical component of FAB is there. The height of the truss is given as 3 meter and each panel has a length of 3 meter. That means this angle will become 45 degree. This angle will become 45 degree. If it is 45 degree, what is the vertical component? It will be FAB sin theta or cos theta, or FAB cos 45 or sin 45, right? So what are the forces in the vertical direction? We have one vertical force here, one upward force is there, I am taking it as positive, 50 kN. One downward force is there, FAB cos 45 or sin 45. FAB, sorry, it is minus FAB sin or cos 45, both will give you the same answer, it's equal to 0. I am taking FAB is equal to 50 divided by sin 45. As we know, sin 45 degree is equal to 1 by root 2. Which will give you the answer as 50 root 2 will be the force in member A. But here in the options, he is given the options like this. 50 root 2 tensile, 50 root 2 kN compressive, 50 kN tensile and 50 kN compressive. So we have to consider the nature of the force also here. The assumed direction was tensile, that means away from the joint. The arrow of the force is away from the joint, that means it is tensile. When it is tensile, I assume it as tensile, I got a positive value. What is the meaning of that? I assume it as tensile, I assume the force member AB as tensile, and I got a positive value. What is the meaning of that? The meaning of that is, the assumption is correct, which means that the force in this member is tensile in nature. Our answer will be 50 root 2 tensile. Option A will be our correct answer. Right? Any doubts? I hope no doubts are there. Right? Any doubts? If you want, you can find the zero force members also there. If you are interested, you can find the zero force members also there. Can you tell me how many zero force members are there? Can anyone tell me how many zero force members are there? Just count the number of zero force members there. Count the number of zero force members there. If you are interested, you can find the zero force members also there. Okay. Yes. Yes, if you have doubts, you can ask me. No issues. Apply all the cases, you will be getting the number of zero force members as 10. You can extend that question to that level also. Okay. Yes. So we are moving on to the next question. We are moving on to the next question. So this will be our next question. It's a gate question actually. You can start solving that question. Try to solve this question. I'll read the question for you. The figure shows an idealized plane truss. If a horizontal force of 300 Newton is applied at point A, then the magnitude of force produced in the member CD is dash Newton. And the truss is also given there. Everyone, please give it a try. We have to find the force in member CD. We have to find the force in member CD. Yes, please write. Srigan Nair, I think you will be getting the answer as 10. Just count the number of zero force members again. You will be getting the answer as 10. Okay. If you have any doubts, you can mail me. No issues. The number of zero force members in the given truss in the previous question will be equal to 10. Okay. Srigan Raushan, please try again. You will be getting the answer as 10. Okay. Yeah. So this is the figure given in the question. Okay. This is A. This is B, this is C, this is D, E and F. Angle is also given as 75 degree. This is G and angle is given as 75 degree. He is asking us to find the force in member CD. Yes, please give me the answer. The question is very simple. Please give me the answer. Force in member CD. Some of you will try to solve this question by using method of section or method of joint. Don't do such kind of things. If you observe the question, you can find many number of zero force members there. If you see this figure, if you see this joint, how many joints are there? Sorry, how many members are meeting there? AB, BD and CB are meeting there. When you see three members are meeting at this joint, and two of them are collinear, third non-collinear member will be a zero force member. It will be a zero force member. We are having a force here that is around 130 kN, right? Sorry, 300 Newton. We are having a load here that is 300 Newton, so it cannot be a zero force member. Two non-collinear members are meeting at this joint, but there is an external reaction. These cannot be the zero force members. Coming to this joint, three members are meeting at this point, at this joint. Two of them are collinear, lying in the same lane. Third non-collinear member will be a zero force member. If this is a zero force member, think about this joint. How many members are meeting there? Three members are meeting there. This is already a zero force member. It has no effect on this joint, right now. So three members are meeting in this joint. Two of them are collinear. Then the third non-collinear member will also be a zero force member. Answer will be zero. The force in the member CD will be zero, right? If you look further, this is also a zero force member. This will also become a zero force member. The entire load acting at this joint A will be transferred to this support through this member and this member. Two inclined members will be there. Right now, the load will be transferred to this member and to this member. It will not be transferred to this intermediate members. All the intermediate members are zero force members here in the given truss. I hope it's clear to you now. Right? Yes. Please note down. If it is clear, we will move further. the force in the member CD is equal to 0. And the number of zero force members in the given truss is also is equal to 4. Member BC is a zero force member, member CD is a zero force member, DE is also is a zero force member, and EF is also a zero force member. I hope no doubts are there, right? Please note it down. And you can move to next question. Please try to solve this question. Yes, one second. Dhruv Gaur is asking one doubt. Joint G is a pin joint or a roller? Dhruv is actually that doesn't matter. It can be a pin joint, it is a roller. It's actually represented as a pin joint. You can consider it as a pin joint, okay? Okay, in the figure it is not mentioned. You have to consider it as a pin joint because in the question it is mentioned that it's an idealized plane truss. You have to consider it as a pin joint, right? Now, roller means it's actually pin roller, okay? So you can go to the next question. I hope Dhruv, your doubt is clear. Yes, fine. Go to the next question. It's an IES question. You can start solving it. It's a very interesting question. Okay. Try to solve it. So this is a figure given in the question. And he is asking us to find the zero force member in it. In the truss shown in the figure given below, which one of the following members has no force induced in it? CD, CE, CF and DF. Yes, you people are giving me the answers also. I'll write the options here. Option A, CD. Option B, CE, I guess, right? It is CE, fine. Option C, CF. And option D, DF. Right? Shall I? Yes. See, here actually we have to think about the zero force members. If you think about the zero force members, consider all the joints. If I consider this joint, we will be having reactions there. That means this is a hinge joint. We will be having one reaction, vertical reaction here. Due to symmetry of loading, the reactions at the supports will be equal. This will be W and this will also be W. Right? Any doubts? The total number of reactions, is total number of loads is W and W. Consider these lengths are equal. Height is also equal. I am considering this angle. It is not given, but still I am taking it as 45 degree. Okay? I am considering it as 45 degree. Then the load is acting symmetrically in the truss. I am taking the reactions as equal. Why? Because when the loads are symmetrical, we can the consider the reactions equal. The reactions of the supports are equal. Now I am going joint by joint. If you consider this joint, two non-bilinear members, but at the joint there is a reaction. So these two are non-zero members. Non-zero members. Non-zero force members, right? If this is zero force, not a zero force member, this cannot be a zero force member. Similar case is there right now. So we cannot go with our case 1, case 2 or case 3. But as he is asking us to find the member who is having zero force, which means that out of these four, one of them is a zero force member. Correct now? But we are unable to judge that zero force member or unable to find that zero force member from the cases we have discussed, you know. So we are going with the conventional approach, method of Johnson, method of section. Otherwise, we will use our logic, right? If I consider our DF, if I consider our member DF, see, consider DF. The member force DF or the force member DF can be obtained by considering joint F or D, correct? If I consider the joint D and if I consider sigma FY is equal to 0, you can find the member force in DF is W, that is tensile. So DF is not a zero force member or the DF will have some amount of force in it, correct? Then coming to CD. So we are unable to judge whether it is a zero force member or not. What I can do, I can use the method of sections. What I am going to do, I am going to cut a section like this. If I am going to cut a section like this, the forces here will be released. Correct? Forces here will be released. If I consider the right part of the section and if I find the moment about F is equal to 0, CD into L is equal to, which is clockwise, is equal to W into L. Which means that CD is equal to W, which is the direction is correct, we will be getting it as tensile. You can find, you can choose the method of section there. Otherwise, you can think, logically you can think. There is a reaction. Due to this reaction, this will have some force in this member. If this is having some force, this member will also have some force. Why? Because if I consider the horizontal component of this member, this will also carry some force. The nature of the force here will be tensile. Right? If this member is having some force, that amount of force will be transferred to this member. if I cancel this joint and cancel the equation sigma fx is equal to 0, we can find that force seats or member CD will carry some force. You can use that logic also to find the force in this member, otherwise to find whether the CD is a zero force member or not. So CD here is not a zero force member. I hope it's clear. Should I repeat? Anyone? We are applying method of sections or method of joints here to check whether it is a zero force member or not. Yes. See, I can find the force in member CD by using method of sections. To use method of section, I am going to cut a section like this. When I cut a section, I can separate the trusses into two parts, left part and right part. I am going to consider the right part. This is the force in member CD. When I cut a section like this, this force will be released. The force in this member is also released. If I consider the moment about F is equal to 0, these two forces are meeting at the point F. It will not create any moment. Only this member will create moment there. FCD into L. I am considering it as L, which is positive. That is, if I consider sigma M is equal to MF is equal to 0, FCD into L, which is clockwise. And what else is creating the moment? W, the reaction to support B is also creating moment there. And clockwise or anti-clockwise? It is anti-clockwise. This force was creating clockwise moment and the reaction will create anti-clockwise moment. Minus W into, this distance I am taking it as L, is equal to 0. From this, FCD is equal to W, which is tensile. Right now, assume direction is correct. We can see that FCD is carrying some force, so that's why FCD is not a zero force member. Otherwise, we can use our logic. Consider this joint, there is a vertical reaction. This vertical reaction will be transferred to this member. The vertical compound of this member, that is our FCD or FB, cos theta will carry that vertical force. And if this is carrying vertical force, horizontal compound will also be there. Horizontal compound will also create some force. Now it will create some force on this member, that is BD. If BD is having some force, if I consider the equilibrium, horizontal equilibrium of the joint D, then we can see that member CD will also carry some force. But we can use that logic, otherwise you can directly use our method of sections to find the force in member CD. Even if you use method of joint through method of sections, you can find that the member will have some force, CD will carry some force. Coming to member CE, Srikant, I think it's clear now, right? Yes. Coming to member CE, if I consider member CE, what is happening there? How to find the force in member CE? Anyone? Yes, how to find the force in member CE? We can cut a section. If I want, we can cut a section. Let's cut a section like this. When I cut a section like this, forget about this section, okay? Forces will be released like this. This force will be released and this force will also be released. I am interested in finding the force in member CF. Correct? I am interested in finding the force in member CF. CE. In order to find the force in member CE, what I have to do? I have to consider the equations. Sigma Fx is equal to 0, sigma Fy is equal to 0, and sigma M is equal to 0. If I consider the force in member CE, what you can see? If I consider the section, down or up or left or right of the section, what I am going to find? I can find that member CF or CE force CF is a vertical force. If I consider sigma Fy is equal to 0, FCE, I am considering sigma Fy is equal to 0. Consider sigma Fy is equal to 0. FCE minus W plus W is equal to 0. Right now, FCE, that is upward force. This is a downward force. Minus W plus W is equal to 0. These minus, this plus and minus will get cancelled. What is remaining? FCE is equal to W. The assumed direction was tensile. I got a positive value, which means that it is tensile in nature. Right now, so CE will also carry some compressive, CE will also carry some force there. It is also not a zero force member. Otherwise, you can consider the right left part of the section also. If you consider the left part of the section, what are the vertical forces there? CE is a vertical force and W, the reaction is also a vertical force. You can directly find that FCE is equal to W. Right? Yes. Coming to, then what is remaining? CF is remaining, which directly says that CF is a zero force member. One of the options should be right now. So CF must be a zero force member. Otherwise, we can check. So you have cut a section like this. When I cut a section like this, three forces are released. EF is released, CF is released, and CD is released. Which equation will I prefer? Yes. Sir, is it necessary that sir member having zero force member is always satisfying? It is not a necessary case for zero force members. Right now? Yeah. Right. So we can easily find that force in member CF is a zero force member. Right?
Yes.
So that was our answer. Our answer will be CF. Right? Should I solve it? See, if you consider, see what will be the vertical forces here? Our vertical forces here will be the vertical component here. That is EF, CF, cos theta or cos 45, whatever it is. If I consider only the vertical forces, what is the downward force? I am taking it as negative. FCF cos 45. One more downward force is there. That is minus W. Upward force is there. Plus W is equal to 0. Plus W minus W will get cancelled. What is remaining? FCF cos 45 is equal to 0. FCF cos 45 is equal to 0. Which means that FCF or the force in member CF is a 0. Or force in member CF is 0 or FCF is a 0 force member. Right? Yes. Any doubts? That's the end of the question. It was a very simple question but asked in IES exam. Many important concepts are there. Right? We have to use method of joints, method of sections, etc. I hope no doubts are there. Right? Any doubts? Yes. So that's the end of the chapter, analysis of trusses. You can go through those concepts. If you have any doubts, you can ask me. We will solve those doubts and we will proceed further. Okay. I have given you my mail ID. You can mail your doubts in that also. I'll be solving that. Many of you are asking doubts. I'm very happy to see that. That means many of you are solving the questions. Okay. Structural analysis is actually completely conceptual. You have to solve n number of questions to make the concept clear. While solving the questions, you will have n number of doubts. If you are trying to solve those doubts on your own, if you are unable to solve them, please ask me. Otherwise, ask someone who can solve that doubt. Okay, no issues are there. If you want, you can ask me. Otherwise, you can ask someone who can clear that doubt. But make sure that that doubt is clear. No doubt should be there in your mind without being cleared. Okay, that's the thing.